So can I ask you a little bit about what I've seen as a major transformation on the Trump side? And it's allayed some of my concerns hypothetically about the manner in which he might conduct an administration. Like, I think he made a major error in the debate with Harris, not stressing continually the makeup of the team that he's gathered around him at the moment. I was joking with some people earlier today about the fact that if I was an American, which I'm not, I would vote for Trump merely because Musk said he would head a commission on investigation into inefficiencies in government. And to me, that's a stunning opportunity, because Musk has shown time and time again that he can do exactly that sort of thing. He has Musk, he has you, he has Tulsi Gabbard, he has J.D. Vance, he has Vivek Ramaswamy. I mean, first of all, these are unlikely Republicans, to say the least, and they're also remarkable people. And so it seems to me that along with the inversion of the Democrats that you described and laid out in multiple dimensions, there's also been a transformation not only of the Republicans in the way you said, but also in the Trump, in the team that's gathered around Trump himself. And so while I'm curious what you think about Trump per se, you've met with him many times now, and you guys have obviously cobbled together something approximating a functional agreement. He obviously listened to you on the health front, but then there's these other people that are surrounding him at the moment too, that seem to be, well, they remind me in some ways of you. They're not the typical political players. They're much more entrepreneurial. They're certainly not classic Republicans. And so how are things going with you and Trump? You said a bunch of things about the Democrats that were critical, but you haven't yet elucidated your opinions with regards to Trump and the team that's around him now. So I'm curious about your sentiments in that regard.
Yeah, I mean, I had, you know, multiple discussions. I got a call from about 2 hours after President Trump's shooting in Butler. I got a call from a guy called Callie Means, mm-hmm. who is a genius who's been on the forefront of reforming our food system and, you know, dealing with the chronic disease epidemic. He and his sister, Casey Means, who did this wonderful interview with Tucker that, you know, introduced a lot of people to them. He called me and he said to me, you know, are you interested in talking to the Trump team about, you know, some kind of a partnership about perhaps unifying your parties? And he and I said no immediately. And then I actually called my family members and talked to, you know, a number of my immediate family members, and they said you should talk to him. My wife said, you know, you should talk to him, but she was not thinking about unifying the party. She was just thinking that he had just been shot, and that, you know, because I came from a background where my uncle, my father were killed by assassins, that it would be a compassionate thing to talk to him. But my kids were, you know, you should talk to him about hearing him out on what he has in mind. And, so I ended up, I then sent Callie Means a text saying, you know, I'm interested. And then a few minutes later, I got a three-way text from Tucker Carlson with an unknown number that was President Trump's cell phone. And he said, you know, will you guys talk? And then I said, yes. And a few minutes later, I got a call from President Trump. And we talked probably for 30 or 35 minutes. And we talked about a whole lot of issues, different issues, and, you know, about his shooting and about the issues that I was interested in. And he expressed a kind of a conformance with me on some of, an alignment with me on some of those issues. And we agreed to meet the next day, and we ended up meeting in Milwaukee, and we had, I think, probably about 2.5 hours together. And at that point, we talked about the food system, we talked about the chronic disease epidemic, we talked about the neocons and the addiction to war. And I was impressed by his just, I would say, visceral revulsion about the neocons and about their view of an imperium abroad and a national security state at home, which go hand in hand because imperialism abroad is inconsistent with democracy at home. And with also his abhorrence for censorship, which he was, again, it was visceral with him. And I think part of that is because he's seen it in action. You know, he's been the target of censorship the same as I have. And so then we agreed that maybe there was a there was grounds to meet on. They wanted me to do something at the convention, the Republican convention, and I was not ready to do anything. And then after that, I actually contacted the Harris campaign to see if she would have a conversation with me. Mm-hmm. And she just said outright no. And then
why do you think that was? I mean, you'd think a conversation
I don't know. I don't, to me, it's unimaginable that, you know, you wouldn't have a conversation, that kind of conversation, particularly because, you know, my because the race can be so close, it's gonna be within 2 or 3 points. And I had a following enough that was large enough to swing it one way or the other. And at least theoretically. So, you know, I wouldn't...
Is it guilt by association? Is it something like that? I mean, I've had a lot of experience with Democrats who would talk to me.
So radioactive in the Democratic Party. And also, they, you know, they believe their own publicity. So they're all reading the New York Times and watching CNN. And if you're living in that information ecosystem, first of all, you'll never see me explain my own issues. What you'll hear is that, you know, I'm anti-vax and that I'm anti-science and that I'm a crazy person and that I'm a lunatic and, you know, all the other things that are just are kind of the standard defamations and perjuries about me on the Democratic-controlled media or aligned media. So, and they're probably believing parts of that, and, you know, so who knows?
That might also be part of
it. I can't look into her mind and explain what they did, you know, why they did. I could speculate a lot, but, you know, what's the point?